Music lovers, hey, we are celebrating classic music on vinyl, and the album of the week is courtesy of Columbia Records. It is entitled Nancy Now by the one and only Nancy Wilson. It was released in 1988. This is executively produced by Dr. George Butler. It's produced by Gene McDaniels, Kiyoshi Hata, Lauren Smokey Bates, and Masahiko Sato. There are 9 songs on this vinyl, and the songs and songwriters are as follows. You Got the Move, C. Ernst, G. McDaniels. Don't Be an Island, K. Evans. Power and the Glory, C. Ernst and G. McDaniels. Ebb Tide, C. Sigmund and R. Maxwell. Rise and Fall of Paradise, J. Bukowski, L. S. Bates. Chasing a Dream, G. McDaniels, T. Silverlight. If I Could, Faye Hirsch, M. Sharon, and R. Miller, which is my favorite song on this album. Quiet Fire, C. Friberg, J. H. Smith. And It's That Time Again, A. Freeman, B. Diggs, and J. Jubert. Now, 10 amazing facts about Nancy Wilson. She won a talent show at the age of 15. She had 3 goals when she moved to New York City, and those goals are to work with John Levy, an influential jazz manager. Secondly, Wilson wanted to sign with Capitol Records, the label who represented her idol, Nat King Cole. Lastly, she wanted to record her first album with producer David Cavana. Her career spanned 5 decades with more than 70 albums released. She did that. She won 3 Grammys, 1 Best R&B Recording, and 2 Best Jazz Vocal Album Awards. She considered herself a song stylist, okay? And that's because she did not limit herself to one genre. For her, songs were about storytelling. In 1993, she told the Los Angeles Times, I have a gift for telling stories, making them seem larger than life. Okay? Her music was empowering for women. Wilson added actress to her resume, appearing on the next few decades on programs such as The Carol Burnett Show and The Cosby Show. She also hosted her own TV show, The Nancy Wilson Show, for which she won an Emmy. She was incredible. I sincerely look up to her. She participated in the Selma to Montgomery March in 1965. She worked with organizations to help black communities in several cities through her philanthropic efforts. She was honored for her activism with the 1998 NAACP Image Award, darlings. She was inducted into the International Civil Rights Hall of Fame in 2005. And lastly, she has been the recipient of numerous awards, accolades, and honors. One being an honorary degree from my alma mater, Berklee College of Music, as well as Central State University in Ohio. Wilson also hosted NPR's Jazz Profiles, a weekly documentary series from 1986 to 2005. She better work. Give her a round of applause, everyone. I mean, my goodness, this lady is incredible. And I sincerely look up to her. Oh my goodness, may she rest in peace, because she was amazing on this earth. She was such a light. And her legacy continues and will continue to be a light. Front and the back. Darlings, beautiful. She was always stunning. Inside and out. All her talent and her actual beauty. So now let's take a second to listen to a snippet of If I Could by Nancy Wilson. She did it first. Yes. This has been Marquita Cheron, singer, songwriter, and music journalist, signing out. Mwah!
Yes, I would. I would help you.